Hello, Sarah here from the Toronto Vegetarian Association. And I know that it's really hard to find yeast these days because it's sold out everywhere. So I'm gonna share with you my favorite recipe for bread you can make that doesn't need yeast. So it's beer bread. Beer has yeast in it, so the beer does the job of the yeast. And luckily for everybody, beer is still really easy to find. It just takes a couple of ingredients and it's really easy to put together. So we're going to start now. Mix the dry ingredients together first. We need 3 cups of flour. So if you don't cook a lot of bread or do a lot of baking, it's really important to sift your flour before you put it in. I'm lazy and I never sift my flour, but what I do is I use a smaller cup and I put it into the larger cup so that it's sort of sifting as it gets measured in. And this just sort of, it prevents you from putting too much flour on your recipe and then making it dense and over floured and too dry. So you just sort of use one scoop to fill the other scoop up. And you do that until you've got 3 cups. Like that. You can also use a weight, a scale, but this is just beer bread, so we're not being super precise. Once we've got our 3 cups of flour, we need 3 teaspoons of baking powder. You need to grab a teaspoon. So 3 teaspoons of baking powder. 1. We always only take half of the baking powder thing off, and that way you can easily level your teaspoon when you're pulling it out of the baking powder. That's 3. 1 teaspoon of salt. And 1/4 cup of sugar. Now, the sugar in the recipe doesn't actually make it sweet. It just helps the yeast rise. It's basically what the yeast in the beer eats when it's cooking. 1/4 cup sugar, and now we're going to add the beer, which is the liquid and the yeast in this recipe, and we need 12 ounces of beer. So if you have a big can like this, it's too much. This is 2 cups, which is, I think, is 16 ounces. So we only need 12 ounces, so I'm going to use a measuring cup, and I'm going to pour out 12 ounces of beer. And you've got a little extra beer left. You can drink that while you're waiting for your bread to be ready. I'm just gonna pour it in and mix the whole thing up. And that's really all there is to beer bread. It's those few ingredients mixed up. I'm gonna post the recipe in the comments here because it's just something I've been using for years. Got a nice bready texture here in the bowl. Actually a little watery, but oh, it's because it's not all stirred up. And then we're going to take our bread loaf pan and just pour the batter in. I like to spray it so that it's not going to stick. And then I'm just going to pour it in. You can add a lot of things to this bread recipe. It's really versatile. I've done olive beer bread before. I like to add garlic to it most of the time, so it's a garlic beer bread. You can see it's just sort of that. What I like to do these days with my beer bread is add some cheese to the top. So we've got cheesy bread. Take some of this cheese, sprinkle it on top. I'll usually also sprinkle some salt on top because I love salt. Just a little bit. And then the last thing you want to add is melted margarine on top.
It calls for a half a cup of melted margarine, but that is a hilarious amount. I usually use like a quarter of a cup, but I'm not even putting it all in. And then, so it looks like this. And just going to put it in the oven and cook it for 60 minutes. And I will come back in 60 minutes and show you guys what it looks like. All right, so 60 minutes in the oven and it looks absolutely amazing. I can't wait to eat it, but it has to cool for about 15 minutes and then I'll slice it up. I've got some vegan margarine and some Wandering Deli vegan cheese that I'm gonna have it with, and it's going to be delicious. So I just wanted to say a couple of things about beer. When I was using the beer for this bread, I used Budweiser. Not all beers are vegan. It's a good idea to double check before you use them. I feel like most of the craft breweries in Toronto are entirely vegan unless they make like a special run of something that has honey or milk in it. But barnivore.com is a resource you can use to see if your beer, your wine, and your spirits are vegan. It's actually made by a Toronto couple who are longtime volunteers of the TVA, so that's great. Barnivore.com, and that's how you can tell if your beers are vegan. Another thing I wanted to say is apparently this recipe only works with alcoholic beer. The beer is cooked, obviously, so the alcohol bakes out and it's not alcoholic anymore now that I'm going to eat it. But also, it doesn't taste like beer, it just tastes like bread. I gave this to my sister for years before she realized that it was beer bread, and she hates beer. So yeah, it passes the doesn't taste like beer test that way. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments and I'll try to answer. And hope this helps you make bread in this yeastless time. Thanks. And as always, if you feel inclined to become a member of the TVA, you can join at veg.ca/join. You can also make a donation there, sign up to become a monthly donor, or just visit the rest of our website for some great resources on being vegan in the GTA. We've got lots of great events coming up. We're going to keep posting these cooking demos on our IGTV and YouTube. So we hope you enjoy all of this stuff we've got coming up while we can not see you guys in person. Thanks.